Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. In this video, I will demonstrate to you sentiment prediction using deep learning. We'll be looking at the artificial intelligence architecture behind sentiment prediction. And then I will also show you a no-code demo using my platform experiencedatascience.com. One of the top applications of sentiment prediction is customer sentiment analysis. It is important because it helps businesses understand how their customers feel about their products, as well as what they feel about the services and overall branding. By analyzing customer sentiment, businesses can identify patterns and trends in customer feedback, which can help them make informed decisions about how to improve their products, services, and in general, the customer experience. In this video, I'll be taking the problem of sentiment prediction from a movie review. Now, movie reviews are a very good way to understand how the sentiment prediction works. Let me start with the movie review, which is shown on the screen. Now, there is a lot of text in this review, and I give you a few seconds to judge if the movie review is a positive or a negative review. Alright, let me reveal the answer and not keep you waiting. The first part of the text has the movie context, and this is followed by a positive sentiment, and it also has got a negative sentiment in the middle, and then it ends up in a positive sentiment. And overall, this movie review has got a positive sentiment. Now, even though it is a very complex text, AI is able to predict correctly the positive sentiment, just like a human. But in addition, it will also give you the probability of sentiment. In the review shown earlier, it will give a probability of 99.6% that the review has got a positive sentiment. In order to better understand the AI architecture, let us first look at the capabilities which the humans use to analyze the sentiment in a text. As humans, we have the ability to understand the words. We also have the ability to identify a sequence of words that can imply a sentiment. For example, the sequence of words in the review are one of the few gems of which day that works well, highly recommended, implies a positive sentiment. We also have the ability to remember from the beginning of the sentence. So for example, in the review, we have a negative sentiment. But we also have the ability to remember from the beginning of this sentence, which has got a positive sentiment. So overall, we tend to give the review a positive sentiment. Now, here is a mapping of the human ability to the AI architecture components. The AI architecture components consist of two parts. The first, we have an embedding layer, which has the ability to understand the words. And the second is the LSTM layer, which stands for long short-term memory. And this layer has got the ability to identify a sequence of words that can imply a sentiment, as well as it has got an ability to remember from the beginning of the sentence. The AI architecture is visually shown over here. The review text is an input to the embedding layer, which is then followed by the LSTM layer, and which outputs the sentiment. Now let us look into the embedding layer to see how it looks visually. The embedding layer converts words into numeric vector representations, which is shown here as a 2D scatter plot. All the dots correspond to words which occur across all the reviews. And the green dots are the words that occur in the review that we are predicting. The power of embedding layer is that each word is converted into a vector, and this signifies that words that are close in the vector space have meaningful relations. So for example, we see that words such as opera, tunes, and entertainment are nearby to each other. So embedding layer is converting words into numeric vector representation and is also doing it in a very intelligent way. Let's now see the LSTM layer. The LSTM layer consists of different units. The layer helps in identifying a sequence of words that can signify a sentiment. And shown here is the LSTM layer in terms of a heat map. and the x-axis has got different LSTM units, and there are about 64 LSTM units, and the y-axis has got watts, and the continuous green color in the heat map indicates that a sequence has been identified by a particular LSTM unit. So for example, the unit LSTM29 has identified the sequence which is nice jazzy tunes like the memorable voice acting and some terrific animation. So this particular sequence has been identified as a sequence which indicates a sentiment. So LSTM are a good example on how AI can mimic a human behavior of reading and understanding a sequence of words. And for the sake of completeness, let me also mention the overall model accuracy when trained on 50,000 reviews. The model has got a embedding layer with 1128 dimensions and 64 LSTM units, and gives an validation accuracy of about 86%. And this model has got more than 11 million parameters. Now let me jump into the demo, and I'll be using my platform experiencedatascience.com. And I've configured this demo on predicting the sentiment analysis and is available over here. You can also try it out for yourself. Let me first start by bringing the movie review data. So let me first select it and then copy it so that it is available for the demo purpose. It will take a while, but now we can see that the data set is available. So let me go ahead and select it and then select analytics. Let me first show you a sample data, and I will select a few records, and there are two columns in the data, the sentiment and the review. So I'll select both of them. Let me now fetch the data. All right, so now we see some sample data, and the first column is the movie review, and the second column is the sentiment. A 1 indicates a positive sentiment. Now let me see some other data, and I can see over here and review with a negative sentiment. And as you can see that this particular record, the negative sentiment is indicated by a 0 in this column. Okay, so now let me go ahead and train the AI model based on the embedding and the LSTM architecture. The input to the model will be the review. Now all the text in the review has got different lengths. However, for the model, we need to give a fixed length. So let me fix the length as 128 characters. So this means that if the review is more than 128 characters, it will be truncated. And if it is less than 128 characters, it will be padded with space. Our target column to predict is the sentiment. And let me now go ahead and select the embedding layer dimension. So just to recall, the embedding layer converts each word into a vector representation. And you can imagine the embedding layer as a table where there is a line for each word across all the reviews. So there could be thousands and thousands of words across all the reviews. So there will be as many rows in the table. What we can set is the width of the table. So here we are going to set it as 128, and this means that each word will be converted into a vector of 128 dimensions. So let me now select the embedding layer output dimension and let me set it to 128. Next, let me set the size of the LSTM layer. The size of LSTM layer determines the number of units which are available to process the input data, and thus has an impact on the model's ability to capture the long-term dependency in the data. Increasing the size of LSTM layer can allow the model to capture more complex sentences and improves the performance, but it also increases the model complexity and the amount of computational resources which are required to train it. So for the moment, I'm going to set it as 64 units. So this means that the LSTM architecture will be able to process 64 words at one time. We can add some additional neurons also to the architecture to process the data, and let me add 5. So the complete AI architecture would look something like this. The embedding layer is the number of words in the vocabulary multiplied by 128, and the LSTM layer has got 64 units, which is then followed by a layer of 5 neurons. So in total, the model is quite complex and it has got about 11 million parameters. Now there are a few other settings which are required, and we can take 30% of the data as test data, which means that the model will take 30% of the whole data and use it to self-validate itself. We need to enter the number of batch, which determines on how the entire data is split. So I'll go and enter 32, which means that the model will be trained in the batches of 32 records. We need to enter the epoch. So an epoch curve refers to a complete pass through the entire data set, which is done during the training of the AI model. It is the measure of number of times the model sees and processes the data during the training. And let us enter 2, and which means that the model will make 2 passes over the data. So increasing the number of epochs can improve the model performance, but it will also increase the time to train the model. Okay, let us now run this monster. Now this model has got about 11 million parameters to train. So it might take quite a long, it might take almost about 20 to 30 minutes. But I will just click the button and just show you the results directly. So after it is run, here are the results what we get. So we get an accuracy of almost about 87%, which is quite good. And we get the confusion matrix. So the confusion matrix is based on the 30% of test data what we had entered earlier. And in the test data, we have about 6,409 reviews with a negative sentiment, and the model has predicted it correctly as negative sentiment. And this is also called as true negative. And there were about 6,556 reviews which has got positive sentiment, which the model also predicted it correctly as positive sentiment, and this is called as true positive. The red cells indicate false negative or false positive, and these are the cells where the model was not able to make the correct prediction. However, the overall model accuracy looks good. We can also go ahead and see some of the predicted records. So here we see the review which was predicted as a positive sentiment. And I have also put some additional visualizations to understand the prediction. So here you have the URL, which is the explainer for the embedding layer. Opening this URL will show the embedding visualization which was shown earlier. And here you have the explainer for the LSTM layer. And opening this URL will show you the LSTM visualization which was shown earlier. So alright my friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please do subscribe to the channel, like and comment the video. And you can also try out the demo at my website experiencedatascience.com. Thank you for watching.